Hi guys, in this video I want to walk you through a technique for painting scorched metal, the sort of effect you'd get at the end of an exhaust or barrel that's been heated up frequently and the metal has turned a bluish purple towards the end. Now for this technique you're going to need variations of these shades and preferably have them all open at once while you're painting. I find it's easiest if you do it all in one go. Don't let the layers dry before you apply the next coat, because it allows the paints to sort of mix together a little easier. Now, so far all I've done on this Dreadnought arm is paint the metal area's lead belcher and applied a black wash. And you can see at the end here, the area we're going to be painting, I've just added a layer of Runefang steel. So the paints I'm using are Mithril Silver. This is you can use any silver here. I'm just using this because my Runefang steel is almost empty. I've got a Gauss Blaster Green. I've got a gold. It doesn't really matter which shade. I've got a Warlock Purple. Now this is an old Citadel paint. So again, any sort of shade of this sort of pinky magenta. I've got a Xerxes Purple, and I've got a Calidor Sky, so a blue. Now these are all the paints we're going to need. So bear with me just a moment while I open all these up. So I've arranged these in the order we're going to need them. And the first step is to mix a bit of silver in with the Gauss Blaster Green. So you're going to want it more on the silver side. You only want a sort of a hint of a bit of green here, and because this is directly under the light, I'm going to add a little bit of water. It never hurts to keep these mixtures quite wet, and we're going to paint the furthest part away from the end of the barrel or exhaust with this greeny mix. When you're doing this, the end result will only have a touch of green, but do paint a little bit extra with the shade, because we're going to need this here to mix into as we move forward. So at this stage, if you can see, it isn't really visible, but that's what we're aiming for. Now, with this mixture still wet, we're going to grab a tiny bit of gold. We're going to throw some gold in this mix as well. And then we're going to start applying here. If you need a bit more, go for it, and then mix it back in with the green we've still got on the palette. So now if we can focus in, it's slowly changing from green to that goldy colour. Now for the next step, I'm going to add a touch more gold. Add a little bit more water as well. And we're going to do another layer, but this time moving even further towards the end. What I tend to find is as you go, the layers become fairly distinct, which we don't want. So I'm going to grab some of the green that's still wet and mix it back in here. So now we can see it's turning more gold. So as this is still wet, we're going to grab some of the magenta. We're going to mix the magenta in again, leaving a little bit of the gold visible. And effectively, if you haven't guessed it already, we're going to keep adding elements of these colours as we go along until we get an effect we're happy with. So I'm going to grab some more magenta, mix it with a little bit more of that gold that's still here. Then we're going to grab some purple. Now these last two colours, obviously they're quite heavy. They're quite dark colours in comparison, so we're not going to want a huge amount of them. Then we're going to start mixing the purple in right at the end here. Again, if you feel that you've got too much of a distinct line between one shade and the other, you should still have the mixture down on the palette here to try and blend them together. And then lastly, I'm going to add some blue. Now the blue, really the only thing we're going to want to do here, I can find a place to balance my arm, is you want just a hint towards the end. So we're just edging the very end of this with the blue. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back with some of the previous colours here. I think as they're drying out, I'm going to have to make some more, which I wanted to avoid. And mix this blue into the purple. The smaller the area you're painting, the more forgiving it's going to be. If you're doing quite a large barrel, I did this technique on a Titan's volcano cannon, and it was obviously harder to do because you had a much larger surface area. It's more difficult to try and blend those colours in a much larger scale and have it so it's still looks effective. But there we go. Pretty simple once you've put a bit of practice in. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to let this dry a little now. Once it is dry, unless there's a really glaring separation between the layers, I would just leave it as it is. If you do feel that there's a real stark difference between, say, the green and the gold, then try and mix up a shade in between and blend it in. But for now, I'm pretty happy with that. And there we have it, guys. What I've done is I've just neatened up the edges here with some bolt gun metal. Lead belcher. I always use the old paint names. And I've thrown some black wash into the recesses here, which covers up any paint that we might have got in there. And that's it, really. That's all there is to it. If this was an exhaust, you might want to dry brush the very end black to represent, obviously, the soot that's on it. But if it was a gun barrel, I would just leave it as it is. Hope you've enjoyed the technique. If you have, leave a like, and I'll see you in the next video.